Hello. Okay, so hello everybody. I am Quân from Vietnam. Today I talk about customized Debian for Raspberry Pi and BeagleBone board. Because I work in IoT. So he prep introduction about me. So I working for a project in South Asia, the sushi Linux, and I have a startup about agriculture technology. So why I come to customize Debian? It's because our project use some Raspberry Pi and BeagleBone board. And we need to remove some components we don't need. For example, when I buy a BeagleBone board, they have some pre-included software, and we don't like it. I want to remove it to have a leaner BeagleBone. And also, the installation of our software to the board it takes very long time, so we want to customize it to include our software, and we want to change some default config because it's the default config is buggy, like the bug with Apache and the bug with command. And we also want it to be automatically built when we update our source code. So there is some hindrance about doing this. Each board family, like Raspberry Pi and BeagleBone, they have its own way to customize the OS, so there is no common way. And the build script are very different. I will show how. Now we see the BeagleBone board. Here is the original build script. This build script is used for many variants of BeagleBone, like BeagleBone black, green, blue. And this script can only run on a real ARM hardware. We cannot run in our PC via KMU. And the last link is my customization. So this is my need to customize it. We want to add some Debian repository. This repository hosts our software package. Like we want to use Python 3.6, but the original repository only have Python 3.5. That's why we have to add the additional repository, and we want to remove some software that we don't need, like Bone Script, Cloud 9. We want to remove the default documentation, and there are some Python packages that we want to include, but we want to build, but that package will need some other library. So we want to include those library to help building Python package faster. So how to do it? Here, these are the files that we need to customize. The first, you see that This is our script. This one is copied from this one. We copy from this one and do some change. The next one is in the chain root folder. So we have, this is the original script. We copy this and modify it and become this. And we write one more script to compile those. The content of this new script is to run, this is the main view script, and then do some additional job like create the SD card image and generate some file to help flashing the image faster, like the bitmap. When you flash the image to the card, normally you use the DD, but the DD take a long time. So the Thaiian project, they invent a new tool called bitmap tool. So that bitmap tool will read some bitmap file and will help flashing the image faster. And we also want to compress the image file so that we can let other people to download it. Here is for Raspberry Pi. The process of customization for Raspberry Pi is different. Here you can see the build script of Raspberry Pi. What good about Raspberry Pi build script is that it can run under KMU and Docker. It means that you can run in your PC. But because KMU cannot emulate the ARM processor fully, so when I customize it, my build script cannot run in KMU because it use some system code that KMU does not support. And the build script, the Raspberry build script is better organized than the BeagleBone because it is split to multiple stages. So you build each stage, after this stage, you move to this stage, and this stage. So when you make some change in one stage, you just rebuild that stage. You don't have to go over again. So it will save you a lot of time. And the stage two is to produce the console operating system without guide. And the stage three plus is to produce the desktop OS. But our application doesn't need desktop, doesn't need guide. So our need to very similar to the BeagleBone, that we want to include some more repository. We want to include some preview binary file for Python packages. And because this board is used in the first year SUSE reload, so the main purpose is to include the SUSE reload software. Here is the building process. So you can see that it is split to many stages. So when you change in one stage, it will rebuild. You don't have to go from the beginning and build again. And because our project doesn't need a desktop OS, so we want to modify somewhere between the stage two and stage three. Here, so the Python allow us to create one middle state. It is state 1.5, and it will run it before state 3, so before producing the desktop OS. And in this state, we just have a similar structure with other states, like we have this file. This one is to list the package that to be installed by apt-get. And this one is the script that will be run inside chain root. Here, our main install script for sushi looks to be run. And here, this is just to have some cleanup job. Like, because inside this script, we start some systemd service. So in this script, we stop those service to let the chain root exit cleanly. And this one, this is just empty file. This is just to inform Python that at this stage we need to produce the image file. And this one is just a copy of other state. Its task is to copy the file produced by previous state. So when we do it and we find some problem, and here is the experience to solve that problem, like inside chain root, don't restart the systemd UDEPD, because when you switch to a chain root environment, you will have to mount some folder, like the dev folder and the sys folder, and the UDEPD will block you from unmount those folder. So you have to avoid starting UDEPD. And if your application needs Java, you need to remove Java first and then install again. I don't really know how this can solve the problem. And in our project, we also do some further customization. So this customization requires us to modify some file outside our stage. Like we want to compress the image with HS. The default build script, the original build script, is to produce the zip. But we found that zip file, it does not help you to flash the image to the SD card faster, because with zip file you have to unzip it to a file and then use that file to flash to the card. But for HS, it helps you uncompress on the fly and write to the card. It saves more time. And we also have a different naming scheme with our file, our image. Here I want to show you how it works in the practice. This is the result of those build script that we use to build sushi Linux. Here, this is the result in the first file when we list the package to be installed by the apt-get. Here, the apt-get is installing our package. Oh, it's very long. Okay. So my talk is finished. Do you have any question? Okay. So you don't have question. Thank you.